Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how you can create new text files anywhere you want in the Finder using a keyboard shortcut. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So something that Windows users miss when they switch over to Mac is the ability to just create a new blank text file anywhere they want. You can do the same thing on the Mac if you create a little script in Automator to do it. So we're going to create a quick action. The reason we're going to use a quick action is that it can be easy to assign a keyboard shortcut to it, as we'll see later. So the quick action is going to run only in the Finder. That's the only place we need this. And it's going to receive nothing as input. So the idea is we want to figure out where the current location of the Finder is. So you have a Finder window open. You want to figure out where it is and then create the new file there. So to figure out where the current location is, we're going to use a bit of JavaScript. So search for JavaScript here. Make sure you have library selected and use run JavaScript in here. And this is where we're going to put our code. So first we're going to put a couple standard lines here. We're going to declare the variable Finder as the application Finder, and we're going to use include standard editions, which will allow us to control the Finder. Now we're going to get the current path. Now we can do this with this piece of code here. This will get the frontmost window of the Finder its target URL. So universal resource locator. So in other words, the location of what's there. Now we're going to test this out to see exactly what is returned when we get this. So this piece of code here will tell the Finder to use display dialog to throw up a little dialog with some information in it, and it's just going to put the current path there. Now to run this, we're going to have to save this first. So go to File, Save, and since it's a quick action, it's going to save it in a special location for quick actions. So let's give it the name we're going to eventually use, New Text File. We'll hit Save. Now I'll go to the Finder with this new Finder window here, and then I'll go to Finder Services, and I'll look for New Text File, and we'll run it. And here's the information we were looking for. It's showing us the current location of the frontmost Finder window. And this is indeed that location. The parentheses 20 stands for the ASCII character 32, which is a space. So local space documents, my space stuff. Now at the beginning here we have file colon slash slash. Much like HTTP colon slash slash you might see when browsing the web. So that's part of a universal resource locator to tell you what this is. It's a file location. We don't need that. We want it to actually just be the first slash and the rest of the path there. So let's get rid of the first 7 characters here. We'll do that by adding a dot slice 7 to get rid of the first 7 characters. And then we'll save this, switch back to the Finder, and now when we run it, we'll get the exact file path that we want. So far so good. So now let's convert the text so we don't have those weird symbols, the percent 20 instead of the spaces in there. Let's go and put decode URI around it. That's a JavaScript function. So by running the return path through decode URI, we should see a normal looking path. So now let's run that inside of the Finder and we see we get a normal looking path with spaces there. So let's save that into a variable. So let's look for set variable. Set value of variable is the next action we want to run. And we want to take what's returned from this. So instead of displaying as a dialog, we're just going to return the current path. And we're going to put that into a new variable. And we'll call that variable current path. And now at the bottom, you should see it appear as a variable. If you don't, you can click this little button here and it shows you all the variables. So now that we have a variable with it in it, we can create a new text file using the new text file action. It's handy that that already exists in Automator so we don't have to program that in. So the file format can be plain text or rich text. We can create a default file name, so we'll call this new file. And then we can determine whether or not we want it to replace if there's already a new file.txt there, whether it replaces it. Safe to have that turned off because you don't want it to overwrite something if you've created a file there and forgot to change the name. Now the where is set to desktop and we can only choose a location. But with this variable down here, we can drag and drop that and replace the desktop with the contents of that variable. So we did all that JavaScript here, returned the current path that went into the variable current path. So it appeared here and then we dragged and dropped it there. So now it should create that file. Let's save and try this out in Finder. And we run it and now it's going to go ahead and there it is. newfile.txt. Let's delete that for now and let's alter it a bit and say not only do we want to create the new file, we want to open it up. So let's do open and open Finder items. And we can put that here at the bottom and say open the Finder items that come out of this new text file action in the default application. So that's great. Now if you don't want to have that, you simply just don't add this there to the end. Let's try it. So I'm going to go Finder, Services, and then New Text File. It creates it and it opens it up. Now there's something in the file. It's the path name of the file itself. What happened here? Well, we set the value of the variable to the current path. And then we pass that into the new text file. So it took that text, not only used it for the where location here as the variable, but also used it as the text in there. Now you'd think you'd be able to control click right here and say ignore input. But if you do so, new text file doesn't work. It wants some input, something to use for the text file. So let's create another piece of JavaScript, run JavaScript, and set that right here. Now here we can go and disable the input, ignore input. So the value of the variable is set and then there's a full break, no input going through to run JavaScript. Now all this JavaScript is going to do is return an empty string, so blank text there. And then it's going to send that into the next thing, which is new text file. So the new text file should be created with blank text. So let me save that, go over to the Finder, let's get rid of that file there. And let's go to Finder, Services, New Text File. And now it's going to create it, open it up, and you can see it's blank. As a plus here, you can go in and put whatever text here that you want. And this will be used as the default text. So that could be a bonus. So now that we have all this worked out, all we need to do is assign a keyboard shortcut to that. So go to System Preferences, and then Keyboard, Shortcuts, then go to Services, and look under General here and you should find New Text File. You can add a shortcut for that. So for instance, let's do Control Option Command N. And now we have that as a shortcut. Now if we go to the Finder again, let's get rid of the file. We can look under Finder Services and we can see that has a shortcut. So let's just do the shortcut. And we can see it creates it and opens it up for us. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.